Canadians produce more garbage per capita than any other country on Earth. Furthermore, when our team put the magnifying glass to our own hometown, Saskatoon, Saskatchewan, we realized that we have a waste diversion rate that is half the national average, which is contributing to our filling landfills. This means we are only recycling half as much as the rest of the country. A new landfill could cost as much as $100 million for the city and place a burden on taxpayers and future generations. One of the highest producers of waste are restaurants, and Saskatoon is known for having the most per capita in the country. Restaurants provide families the ability to socialize and get out of the house with their kids, and many provide coloring pages and crayons, which are a great way to entertain the kids while waiting for their food. Before the COVID-19 pandemic, some restaurants would reuse the crayons until they were too small or broken to be used again. But since crayons cannot be sanitized, they are now a one-time use item and get tossed in the garbage after each table, used or not. This creates a huge waste problem. While you may not think something as small as a crayon may not be initially thought of as harmful to the environment, but because they are a petroleum product, they don't break down and have a negative impact on the landfills. The good news is that some petroleum products, like crayons, are also very easy material to recycle because they can be melted down to make new ones. Hi, my name is Caitlin Peterson. I am a member of the Enactus team at the University of Saskatchewan, and I am here to share my project, Recolor. As a server for over 7 years, I have seen firsthand the amount of waste that used crayons produce and wanted to find a solution to the problem. The solution I came up with was to collect these crayons, full, broken, or bits, and recycle them into new ones to be donated or sold. This will stop them from heading to the landfill and also reduce the need to produce new ones, creating a full circle benefit. This begins by partnering with local restaurants in the community. By being a part of this initiative, they are reducing their own waste, reducing their cost of disposal, showing that they care about the environment, and benefiting from positive PR our team provides from being involved in this initiative. The majority of managers we have spoken with love this idea to address the crayon waste issue they have also noticed. We give each restaurant a crayon collection bin to place in an easily accessible location where servers and hosts can drop off the used crayons. These bins are made using upcycled tin cans from a restaurant so they can be easily sanitized. Once the bin is full, an Enactus team member will go and collect the crayons, typically on a bi-weekly basis depending on the need of the restaurant. In the first step of the production process, the crayons need to be individually peeled and sorted. This step is the most time-consuming, but also provides a great team bonding opportunity. Their wrappers are being collected until a more sustainable recycling process can be developed for them. The next phase involves melting the crayons down and pouring them into an aluminum mold. The mold was designed to be the ideal length and width for kids so they don't break them too easily, but are also still small enough to handle. The newly formed crayons are then removed from the mold and stored in reusable containers. Since the raw materials are all recycled and the majority of the equipment is upcycled, there is little startup cost and minimal continuing cost. The biggest purchase was the molds, but these are a one-time buy. Operating costs include the gas to travel to collect the crayons and eventually packaging to redistribute. The majority of the crayons will be donated to places and organizations who can use them to bring joy to kids through crafts. This will be places like youth centers, foster homes, daycares, and classrooms. We plan to approach elementary school teachers, as many of them purchase school supplies out of their own pocket. By donating our crayons to their classroom, we will reduce this extra burden for them. Although operating costs are minimal, to keep the project self-sustaining, we will sell crayon sets at local craft fairs, stores, and online. A set of crayons can sell for between $2 to $6, depending on the quantity and shape. This will allow the project to be self-sufficient and produce a small profit to be put back into the project. Since the project has begun, we have partnered with 6 local restaurants and collected over 3,000 crayons. Although crayons are small, keeping them out of the landfills will have a huge impact. By recycling the crayons, it is lowering the need to produce new ones, which creates pollution and also keeps the used ones out of the overflowing landfills in Saskatoon. Thank you.